Start at 9 a.m.
10 a.m.
10 a.m. I'm there pretty early, so I don't actually. Anyways, so we meet over there. We would love to meet you guys afterwards. Just come say hi to any of us. I can vouch for all of these beautiful people. They are fantastic to talk to. So we love you guys, and if you feel so inclined, you can stand with us and worship. You can stay seated, whatever your heart desires.
Bye.
Sing Amazing Grace. And you know, I didn't know what that was when I was a kid, but I kept singing that song throughout my days. And you know, I went through some rough battles in my life, but we aren't here just to make music, and you know, that's all fun and good, but we are here because we have a relationship with Jesus Christ, and He has redeemed us from our brokenness, and He has redeemed my life. He's redeemed so many lives up here on this stage. And so we are here because of Him, not just because of music. And I have one little scripture for the evening, and this is out of Isaiah, and this is a writer before Jesus was even born in the Old Testament. It says, "But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the chastisement that brought us peace." The world could use a lot of peace. "And but with his wounds, we have been healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have all turned, every single one, to his own way. And the Lord has laid on him, our Savior, the iniquity of us all."
Thank you. us tonight. I hope you're having as good of a time as we are up here, just praising the Lord. I hope you're enjoying it. I wanted to take a quick second and just pray for us as we have a couple more songs for you guys. I just want to pray for the city of Ceres. I want to pray for the hearts of the people. I want to pray that the Spirit of the Lord just comes upon this city in such a powerful way tonight and moving forward, that hearts are going to be changed here in this place tonight and here in this city. So I just want to pray that for us. Father God, I thank you for who you are and who you've created us to be. I thank you for giving us the opportunity to just come before you and praise you, lift up a shout, and bring glory to your name, Father God. I pray that tonight you're working in the hearts of the people of Ceres, that this city is changed and transformed by you, that we see a revival here in this place tonight, Father God. That your presence is just so powerful, Father God, and we know that the prayers of these people are being heard by you now. I thank you for sending your Son down for us, that we don't have to be ashamed, Father God, that Jesus who came wipes our sins away, that we get to be with you, Father God. I thank you for the opportunity that we have to just be so mesmerized by who you are, that we can constantly be reminded of how in awe of everything you've done. We need to be in awe of who you are, Father God. Your creation, the sunrise and the sunset and the beauty of all the things, Father God. I thank you for that opportunity that we have to just come before and to worship you. And I pray for the city of Ceres tonight that an impact would be made, that we would see a change in the hearts of these people. I pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Power has
listening to this?
us, ask about music, whatever it is. We would love to talk with you and spend some time with you guys, but thank you for having us.
You know, John 17:4, Jesus said to the Father, I will bring you glory by keeping your commands. Now, think about this. Jesus gave his life on the cross to bring the Father glory. We ourselves, we can bring the Father glory by keeping his commands in the way of sharing God's love and his truth and the gospel and the good news. And when we do that, we can do it in a way by keeping, well, Jesus said, I'll roll all the commands up into these two. Love the Lord God with all your heart, mind, body, soul, and strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself. So we as Christians need to push each other to grow and to share that good news. Be blessed.
5 years up until March when I retired, Richland Faith Assembly of God. And I know we've got visitors from other places and other churches, and we're glad that every one of you are here this evening. But we're going to put together something, two groups that have been singing for a long time, the Richland Trio and the Herb Henry Family. And so we're going to start out with the trio, and we've just been having a reunion. The trio disbanded back in 2013, and one of our members lost his mind and moved to Texas, and he's here visiting with us, and we'll introduce him a little bit. But we've been having a reunion, and we've been having a good time. And Rick's flying back to the Lone Star State tomorrow, so he was here just long enough to be here tonight. And he's also been playing in the Mo Band? Mo Band. Anybody know what Mo Band is, huh? Well, he's been part of that. But let's get started, okay? Here we go. Those guys sung that song 8 years. Honestly, they haven't sung it in 8 years till right now, and we're going to be doing a lot of that next few minutes. So get ready, Ray.
Is that why you're hitting on me?
I just want to say this now. I played the piano for this group, did the arrangement of music over the years, so I'm just taking it easy and rolling in the seats. But as I referred to a while ago, March 7th it was that I retired after 35 years of Richland Faith, and a young man has stepped into the helm there at the pulpit of Richland Faith, and that's Richie Hartsfield. And Richie, how about it? What's been going on at Richland Faith this week?
Well, we had a VBS, and let me tell you, I am worn out. Those kids can wear you out, but we had a great turnout. We had a wonderful time, and the Lord was lifted up. The kids had a great time. The adults are still recovering. I took about 3 naps this afternoon in preparation for today, so we are charged and ready to go. So we're going to have a good time tonight. And I think we got an old song coming up. All our songs are old. We got old men in our group. We got to have old songs.
Come on.
Right? So kick it off there, Chris.
Soul of man is like a ship that sails on the sea of time. The storms may come and the winds may blow and rock this ship of mine. But the reason my ship has never sank and today is still afloat, my compass is His holy word and Jesus pilots my boat. I won't sail this stormy seas no more unless Jesus leads the way. I won't ever drift so far from the shore. I can't hear what He has to say. For I belong to a fleet that sails today on a glorious one-way trip. Safety's port, my stern was torn apart. The bow of my vessel was so badly crushed, sin's waters flooded my heart. I had sailed so long on life's angry waves with my cargo of fear and despair. But I called on His name and He lifted the blame. Now He pilots my ship everywhere. Stormy seas no more unless Jesus leads the way. I won't ever drift so far from the shore. I can't hear what He has to say. For I belong to a fleet that sails today on a glorious one-way trip. Well, and safely on shore to sail. I won't sail this stormy seas no more unless Jesus leads the way. I won't ever drift so far from the shore. I can't hear what He has to say. For we belong to a fleet that sails today on a glorious one-way trip. Well, then safely on shore to sail. Pilots my ship. Well, I'm safely on shore to sail no more. For Jesus pilots my ship.
I just want to say how much we appreciate the opportunity to come out here this evening. You know, the Richland Trio was part of the very first concert series here in Whitmore Park back in 1989. And we sang here every year for a good long stretch. Our families sung many times here, and we appreciate the opportunity to be back this evening. Well, this is my old partner, singing partner Rick Hartsfield. You know, Rick and I have known each other now for 50 years.
Wow.
One of these days, wow. I'll get a break. But, Rick and I met 1971, and he became part of the Premieres, a quartet that we had back in those days. And we traveled all over the country in our bus, had some good times. And then in 1987, he and I and the late Jack Black formed the Richland Trio. And we've had some wonderful times here in the San Joaquin Valley and up and down the state. And Rick, why don't you do a special song? And, you know, the last year or so, we've lost some dear ones to this virus that's still around us today. And I'm so glad for the hope that the gospel gives us beyond those days of sorrow and parting. Listen as Rick sings for you.
Beside me and my soul's found victory. I passed over.
Things? No, you don't say nothing.
No.
So about 150 years ago, Dad wrote this song, and he was only in his 50s then, but a long time ago, huh, Dad? He wrote this song, so I think we're going to close out with this one. And how many can say tonight that you are redeemed by the blood of the Lamb? Amen? All right.
Richland Trio, how about that? Fellas, thank you so much. And Texas by FedEx tomorrow. It's going to take a big box. Big box. Well, right now, we're bringing up the Herb Henry family. We've been singing since 1986. And I'm sorry to say that the loudest voice of our group is not here tonight. Amanda Joy is in Nashville. She had to fly there last night to sing at a funeral tomorrow for our dear friend, Stone Mountain. We call him Stony Dart. And Stony was only 43 and passed away after a long bout with cancer. And they've asked her to come back and sing at his funeral, which is in the morning. And so she regrets that she can't be here tonight with us. But a young lady who sang with our group for over 20 years and sang the other female part is taking her sister's place. And Angela Cowell is here to sing Amanda's place. And so we're going to see what we can do with it, okay? And I love this song. It says, "My hope is in the Lord."
Built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. He's the rock that keeps me satisfied. In Him I find this perfect peace. It gives me joy and sweet release. Just to know He's standing by my side. My hope is in the Lord. I'm trusting in His word. The winds may try to shake me, but His hand holds me secure. Though hell may rise against me, it cannot make me fall. I will not be defeated, for my hope is in the Lord. When I am weak, my Lord is strong. He turns defeat to victory song. Gives the strength my heart's been longing for. There's not a danger that can harm. When thunder rolls, I'm not alarmed. He's the shelter in the raging storm. My hope is in the Lord. I'm trusting in His word. The winds may try to shake me, but His hand holds me secure. Though hell may rise against me, it cannot make me fall. I will not be defeated, for my hope is in the Lord. My hope is in the Lord. I'm trusting in His word. The winds may try to shake me, but His hand holds me secure. Though hell may rise against me, it cannot make me fall. I will not be defeated, for my hope is in the Lord. I will not be defeated, no. I will not be defeated, for my hope is in the Lord. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name.
On Jesus' name.
On Jesus' name. My hope is in the Lord. I'm trusting in His word. The winds may try to shake me, but His hand holds me secure.
Songs. Pastor Richie Hartsfield of Richland Faith Assembly of God is going to step out and lead us in this great song about prayer. Every one of us can pray.
A force lies within our hands, of power not known to man. It opens the door for all that's in store for those who obey. It's where miracles wait for you, and mercy comes shining through. Just let's see what the Lord can do when somebody prays. Somebody prays, and heaven pays attention. Somebody prays, and angels listen. And strife just won't go away. Oh, but church, here's the good news. Then strength comes down from above and touches that hurting one, and faith rides on wings of love when somebody prays.
Do Amanda's song for you, okay? This one gets up and moves on down the road just like the freeway up here. Let's see if we can do it. Catch your foot along.
When I wake up in the morning, I'm gonna lay these burdens down. Lay these burdens down. Lay these burdens down. When I wake up in the morning, I'm gonna put on a Roman crown. When I wake up in the morning, one of these days.
Today I live in a world of sin, but I know what lies ahead.
I know what lies ahead. I know what lies ahead.
There's a mansion that's prepared for me. That's what my Jesus said.
When I wake up in the morning, one of these days.
Shall come, but I know I'm going there.
Jr. Henry family coming up real quick and doing a song for us, okay? They've been singing for a while. They sang before, 3,000 people down in Visalia a couple of years ago before the Fan Fest was shut down for the past year and a half. So they're veterans. And I've got a microphone for Lawton here.
Thank you.
Fiddle music around here, huh?
Yeah.
Well, maybe you like, do you like highbrow or Grand Ole Opry? Which one? Which one do you like? Well, this young lady, I think, can play either one. And I don't know what she's going to do, but this is my oldest grandchild. This is Melody Bell. She just turned 16. That means she's getting her driver's license. That's fair warning for every one of you. Okay? But she's going to play whatever she's chosen to play. Melody Bell.
Yes,
the standing ovation in any town, let me tell you that. Melody Bell. By the way, she's going to be in Orlando, Florida next month at the General Council of the Assemblies of God for the Performing Arts. She's going to be performing back there. So just say a prayer that she has a good experience back there, okay? Well, we're going to do two more songs. Actually, I'm going to bring the trio back up, and we're going to finish out with a very familiar song we all know, we all can sing. But this is our final song for the family. One of the greatest songs we've ever done. And before we sing it, let me just mention that, hold it, son, because I'm giving you a plug, okay? No, it's been a wonderful thing. You know, Chris has been with me all the way. He's been part of our church at Richland Faith Assembly of God. He was 10 years old when he came there in 1986 with our family. Grew up there, developed his ministry. And then a year and a half ago, this church across the street came open and they invited him to come and be a candidate for the pastor. Well, they voted him in. And he's been there a year and a half, and it was wonderful for that 1 year, he and I both were pastoring here in Ceres together. And that was something that you just can't pay money for. And it's been wonderful. And Angela has been his worship leader, and the kids are part of the worship band. Matter of fact, they have a worship band. They didn't come tonight because we don't have room for both trains. But anyway, they've got a great ministry going over there. But this is what it's all about. As I look across the street and see the cross, that represents something. We know what it represents. And we're going to present it to you right now in one of the finest songs we've ever sung. Chris is going to step out and lead us on Once Upon a Cross.
Time. One monument of mercy stands.
Junior family? Dad in Hartsfield? Come on up here and let's sing a song everybody knows, and you can join with us on this one, okay? How many have ever heard of I'll Fly Away?
Not one of you?
Not one?
What country are you from?
Come on. Who's heard of I'll Fly Away?
That's an American tradition. I'll Fly Away. Here we go.
Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore.
Singing here tonight, the music. Would you stand with me and do this with me before we leave? God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans, white with foam. God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless America, my home, sweet.
Love America tonight.
Yes.
We love this land. Would you bow in a word of prayer with me? Father, thank you for this glorious place. We love so dearly America and how America needs your presence and your power and your touch today because we're going through perilous times. We pray that for our leaders that you will help them and guide them and bring them together. Bring our people together, Lord, and help us to realize we have the greatest thing in the history of this world going for us. Lord, we can't lose it. We can't squander it. We must guard it, protect it for the sake not only of ourselves, but our children, our grandchildren, our loved ones. Help this land. Help us to do our part, Lord. Reach down with your healing hand and touch our land and touch this world with your amazing grace. And let us be a light for you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. God bless you. Thank you for coming tonight. It's been a glorious time. And I think we have another word here from the mayor. Is that right?
Hello, everybody. I'm so grateful that everybody showed up today. This is a great opportunity for everybody to get together. And I do have an announcement because I know everybody loves tacos. Carlos just told me, he informed me that tacos are going $1 a taco if you guys want tacos on the way out.
He doesn't.
So once again, thank you everybody for coming out here. It's not over. We have two more Fridays left. So come on out and God bless everybody and God bless.